Sit simple cross legs on a bolster and join your hands in front of your chest. Allow the intelligence from the temples to drop down to the level of your shoulders. Gently relax the jaw and rest the tongue on the lower jaw. The eyes should close by now. Listen to your breath. Let the breath come in and go out as it likes. And now repeat after me. Gurur Brahma,
Gurur Brahma,
Gurur Vishnu,
Gurur Vishnu,
Gurur Devo Maheshwara,
Gurur Devo Maheshwara,
Gurur Sakshat Param Brahma,
Gurur Sakshat Param Brahma,
Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha,
Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.
Om
Om
Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Gently release your hands and place them on your thighs and open your eyes. Welcome to our first session of yoga. In this session of yoga exercises, we will stay with the beginner's method and the beginner's postures. So as we practice the yoga postures here, we will make sure that we do not have any difficult postures or asanas to perform. And we'll stick to very simple exercises that can be done by anybody and everybody unless they have an ailment. Having said that, it is always advisable to refer to your doctor before attempting to start any exercise routine. Now, twist to your right. So turn completely to the right. Take the right hand and placing it on the bolster, push the bolster with the heel of your palm. Take the left hand and place it on the outer side of the right knee. That's right. Do not use the fingers and do not pressurize the fingers. Do not also involve the palm of the hand, but take the governance of that posture on the heel of your palm. Push with the right heel, pull with the left heel of your hand. Rotate at the shoulders. Normal breathing. Open the underarms and flex the left elbow along with the right. With the inhalation, open the sternum and lift up the chest. With the exhalation, rotate the mass of the body around the spine. And now inhale and come to the center. To make sure that we have even timing given to both sides when we do lateral moves, we will move with a timer. So change the position of your legs. The right leg goes behind, the left leg comes in front. The same way that you had done before. A twist to the left. Again, push with the heel of your left hand on the bolster. Right hand comes on the outer left knee. Right hand, please. Yes, left hand behind. Push with the heel of your left palm. Pull with the heel of your right palm. Do not collapse the chest, open the chest, flex the elbows. Allow the mass of the torso to rotate around the spine. Look over your left shoulder. With the inhalation, open the chest. With the exhalation, rotate the torso around the spine. Almost as if it were like the fireman coming down the pole, only in reverse. Try to keep the weight equally on both the sit bones. And now get ready to come back. Come back to the center. Place your feet in Baddha Kona Asana. We will stay in Baddha Konasana for a minute. And stay there. It is important to understand how the Baddha Konasana came about. In the earlier days, cobblers would fix people's footwear by sitting in this posture. They would place the footwear, the shoe or the sandal, between the legs, anchor it over there and use their hands to stitch, nail and repair the shoe. There was also an anvil and they would place it on the anvil and beat on it. As a result of sitting this way the whole day, it was found that cobblers in India were very healthy in a sexual way. They had no sexual dysfunctions and they rarely ever contracted an illness that was sexually related or an STD. And that's how this pose came into postures.
So this is also a butterfly pose, no?
No, we don't do that because it's ballistic stretching.
What happens with butterfly?
You're stretching wrongly. It's a ballistic stretch. Twist and look over the right shoulder in Baddha Konasana. The right hand goes behind. Now pressurizing the back of your hand against your lower back, rotate the whole torso. You may also, if you wish, place the heel of your right palm on the bolster and rotate. But try to keep the shoulders in line. So lift up the left shoulder, drop the right shoulder. Lift up the left, drop the right, yes, and now rotate. Inhalation opens the chest, exhalation rotates the mass of the torso around the spine. There is a tendency to take the weight on one buttock bone or one sit bone. Make sure that you shift in a way that both sit bones are equally placed on the bolster. The position for holding the feet is correct. In this case, you're holding it from the side. Now change the side and twist in the opposite direction. Hold the feet with the right hand. Take your left hand behind. Drop the left shoulder. Lift the right shoulder up. Drop the left shoulder, yes. And keep rotating the body. The body now rotates counterclockwise. Right shoulder goes up, left shoulder goes down. Push the back of your left hand into the lower back and open the chest and lift up. Relax the hips so that the knees fall down gracefully. Do not stiffen the neck muscles, relax the neck muscles. And now, slowly inhale and come up to the center. Now, the next pose is what we call the birdie pose or the Pakshiya Asana. You will straighten both your legs in Dandasana. Now, slightly bend the left leg and taking the right leg from under the bent leg, place the foot on the bolster. Right hand on the outer side, take your left hand behind and twist and look over the left shoulder. Keep working on the twist. Open the chest. Keep rotating. Relax the neck muscles, gentle smile. And now prepare to come back. change the side now. Now the left leg will go on the bolster and the right leg will come over it. Twist and look over the right shoulder. Always keep your shoulders in level.
How was it? I forgot.
Yes, that's it. That's it. That's it.
My shoulders are stiff, finally.
That's okay. That's perfectly okay. Awareness of the problem is greater than having a lesser problem with no awareness of it. Now, that's good. That's an intermediary relaxation for your hips if you like. Now, bend your left leg, right leg in Virasana and place it on the bolster. Yes. Okay. And twist and look over the left shoulder. Right. Now, as you do that, bend your left leg and place the foot on the floor. Yes. Take your right hand over. Yes. Keep working on the pose. There are many, many different variations. Each individual must choose what works best for him. Try to avoid sitting on the right foot and keep the right foot outside on the side at the, on the bolster. That's right. That's right. And keep twisting. Avoid dropping the shoulders at an incline. So the right shoulder goes down more. The left shoulder comes up. You may even bend the arm and the elbow like Mahasaraswati. And look at me and do that with the right hand. Yes, you may do that if you like and resist. Yes. If it is comfortable for you, but you are trying to get the body to twist, get ready to come back. Change the side. Bend the left leg in warrior, bend the right leg and place it on the floor, place the right foot on the floor and now rotate and look over the right shoulder. There are several ways in which people can do this pose. Sometimes you may want to pull the knee of the right leg with your left hand and rotate. Keep twisting. It is always important to time your poses when you are doing lateral posturing. So this is in order to avoid doing it more on one side than on the other side. So whenever you are twisting left or right, that's how you do it.
Number of breaths?
Number timer. In the earlier days they used the breath in order to time. In the modern day, you don't need to use the breath. We have electronic timers that can do it. So they would count, say, 10 breaths on one side, and then they would balance by counting 10 breaths on the other side. We don't need to do that today because we have timers. Okay, again, put both your legs in the front. Okay? Now, you had the right leg in warrior for the first time. So, again, bend the right leg and place it in warrior. And now, this time, you will bend the left foot and place it on the right thigh. Look at me. Right? And holding that right foot with your right, left foot with your right hand, twist and look over the left shoulder. Take the left hand behind, yes. Always don't raise one shoulder more than the other. Try to keep them in line. Your breath is your greatest friend. Keep watching the breath, and with every exhalation, keep twisting the body around the spine. As you keep doing it more and more, also keep pulling on the left foot with your right hand. If you wish to, you may take the right knee a little more to the right. Right knee. More to the right. Yes. So that will give you a better range of motion when twisting to the left. Now get ready and change. Now put the left leg in warrior. Left leg goes in warrior. Bend the right foot and place it on the left thigh. Twist, holding the right foot with your left hand, twist and look over your right shoulder. Drop the right shoulder a little and lift the left up so that both shoulders are in line. Get ready to come back. Straight legs out there. Let us align the body a little more by doing another twisting with simple cross legs. So simple cross legs, the right name for this pose is Swastikasana. It is called Swastikasana because it is named after the swastika, which is the laterally opposite image of the Om. Okay, it was borrowed by other cultures, but it is originally a symbol of the Aryans from the north of India, not to be confused by any other race. Okay, so the legs cross in such a way that forms a swastika, that's why it's called a swastikasana. Now we will do a twisting and a bending. So twist to the left, keep your right hand on the outer side of the left thigh, take the left hand behind, yes, but don't twist it behind, place it on the bolster by your side, and that is the twisting. And now go down, go forward to you and down, that's the bending. So you twist and you go down. You may place your hands on the floor, both hands on the floor. No, do not place the forearm, just the hands on both sides, the right hand also, and exhale and keep going down. Keep using the exhalation to relax the body and fall forward. Occasionally, you may also, if you wish, take a deep inhalation. An extended, prolonged exhalation following that will help you to go down more and more, more and more. And now, get ready to come back. Inhale and come back up. come up. Change the position of your legs. Change the sides. No. That's it. Yeah. No. Simple. That's not swastikasana. That's not even siddhasana. Look at me. The other side. The left leg will be in the front, the right leg will be behind. Yes. But don't fix it there, just keep it loose. Okay. It is perfect to make videos with the mistakes because we are all human. And it's good to see our humanness. I do not like to make perfect videos. I think the imperfections in our videos help us to grow more. Twist to the right. Right hand goes on the bolster. Left hand goes on the outer side of the right knee. And then eventually, after you've completed the twist, you will exhale and go down. In which case, both hands can go on the floor and keep going down with a twist. Keep going down with a twist. Drop the left shoulder more than the right. Then you will experience a twist better. So left shoulder drops down, right shoulder comes up. Observe how the body twists in this position. And now get ready to come back up. Again change the sides. Back to Swastikasana with the right leg in the front. Yes, you do it better on this side. Interlock your fingers and then stretch them up. Remember which index finger is in the front because we will change it in the following posture. And keep stretching up. The pinky comes down, the index finger goes up. That will give you a twist on your wrists. Breathe normally. Yeah. Bring the elbows closer to each other. Open the sides of your body completely. From the hip to the shoulders, lift up. From the shoulders to the elbow, lift up. From the elbow to the wrist, lift up. Normal breathing. Allow the breath to come in and go as it likes. Make sure that you're taking the weight equally on both the sit bones. Make sure that you're breathing into the side ribs. Deep inhalation. Relax, passive outgoing exhalations, focusing on the side ribs, the inner eyes at work, and now bring the hand down. Change the sides of your legs. Don't do that. Bring the left leg in the front and keep it loose. In the front. Just, yes, that's better. Don't tighten it there. Relax it. Okay, there you go. Very important because you always do that for one side. That's because of the dual brain that we have. Change the interlock of the fingers. If your right index finger was in front, take the left in front now. Yes, and now take it up. Yes. One side is always easier than the other. Observe that. Try to take the pinky down towards the floor and the index finger up towards the ceiling. That will give you a particular twist in the wrists of both the hands. Once you have done that, focus on bringing the elbows closer to each other. Bring the elbows closer, do your best. Don't force, but be firm with yourself. Being firm will not create damage, but will help you grow faster. Forcing may damage part of your body, which will be very difficult to recover in the long term. Open up the sides, hips to shoulders, shoulders to elbows, elbows to wrists. Deep breathing, breathe in, breathe out, and now relax and come down. Again, change the sides of your legs. Not like that. Bring that outside and place it on the floor, and yes, there you got it. There you got it. Okay. Interlock the arms at the elbows. Remember which elbow you put up, because you will need that when you're changing. Relax the lower body as you stretch the upper body, which begins at the hips. From the hips to the shoulders, lift up, extend by a couple of inches. From the shoulders to the elbows, extend by a couple of inches. Now there are a few movements that you want to incorporate in this pose. Holding your elbows with both your hands, try to rip those elbows apart, and you'll feel an opening inside the shoulders. Simultaneously try to lift by a couple of inches above your head with the arms. Once you have done those two movements, then try to take the hands the way they are, bent at the elbows, behind you by 2 or 3 inches, away from you, in the back. So you go up, apart and behind. And now release, bring your hands down. Change the crossing in your legs. Always, the left leg will come in the front first. No, first bring the left, yes, okay, just leave it there, yeah. Even when we are working with our automobiles, we do wheel balancing. We bring the front tires to the back and the back tires to the front, because there is an uneven wear and tear on the tires. In the same way with our bodies, there is an uneven wear and tear depending on our attitudes, our behaviors, and the way we respond to our thoughts and others in life. So that is why we do this, so that we balance our body well. Again, take your hands up. Put the opposite hand on the top now. Yes, left hand is on the top. Again, there is a simple way in which we place our hands this way. There is also a more intense way in which we can do it. To increase the intensity, from the hips to the shoulders, lift up. Now, from the shoulders to the elbows, lift a little more. Third point. Holding the elbows, try to rip them apart, away from each other, but the hands will prevent them from going apart, while the elbows try to go away from each other. That is the second intensity. The first intensity is shoulders going up. Second intensity is shoulders going apart. And the third intensity is, while these two are going apart and above, take the full construct of your hands behind you, away to the back. Keep taking it away, and you will feel a powerful energy working on your shoulders. And now, release and come down. Now we will just sit there quietly for about a minute without doing anything, totally unmoving, until we come to the next posture. Use that breath to keep looking at the body. All the time when we do yoga postures, we tell the body what to do. It is at these moments that we listen to what the body is telling us. The body does not talk in languages like English and German and Japanese and Sanskrit. The body talks through sensations. This was found by the Buddha who created Vipassana. So listen to the body, and it will tell you, and it will give you myriads and myriads of information, which you will learn to sort out as you grow on the path of yoga. And now slowly open your eyes and come back. This time we will work separately on the shoulders. So you will take your right hand behind you, and with your left hand you will pull the right elbow away from you. Yes. And keep doing that. Again, don't push it to the side, push it directly behind. Look at me. Don't do that, but push it directly behind. Yes. Yeah, and keep this elbow also behind, the left elbow also. Yes. Wonderful. Now, again from the hips to the shoulders, take the body up. While you're doing that, try to get the knees to go down slightly. That will create space in the abdomen. It will create a separation where the sitting part, which is below your hips, goes downwards and the rest of your body from the hips goes upwards. Now from the right shoulder to the right elbow, stretch vertically up. But from the left elbow to the left hand and the left shoulder goes directly behind. Yes. And now slowly get ready to come back. Change the side. Left hand. Pull the left elbow with the right hand. Keep working. Again, as you lift from the hip to the shoulders, allow the body from the hip to the knees and from the knees to the feet to drop down. Now, left shoulder to the left elbow stretches and goes to the back. So raise from the left shoulder to the left elbow. That's the stretch. While it's going back, also take the right shoulder, the right elbow and the right hand back along with it. Breathe into the side ribs. Breathe into the side ribs. Occasionally a deep inhalation followed by an extended exhalation will help you to release and go deeper. And now come back. Yes. Now Uppavistha Konasana, where you spread both your legs to the sides. In most sitting postures, people tend to point their feet. Never point your feet. Also, dropping your toes to the side is going to make you lose your energy. So bring the toes up so that the weight is equal on the inner and the outer heel. So this is your inner and outer heel. So bring the toes even more and dorsal flexion of the feet. No. Yes, dorsal flexion, which is also technically called flexing. Pointing the toes away is called plantar flexion or pointing. Okay. Now, keep your right hand where it is. Take your left hand up and exhale and go and hold the right foot wherever you can. It is not important to hold your foot. What is important is that you do not bend your knees and that you do not force your body down. As you learn to stay in the posture, the body will automatically give in. Allowing the body to descend is figuratively connected with falling in love. When you fall in love, whether it's a deity or whether it's a person of the opposite sex, if you keep forcing yourself onto that person, you will destroy the relationship. If you force yourself in a posture, you will destroy the pose. So wherever you are, stay there. There is no competition. There is no judgment. It's a process of observation. It's a process of understanding. And as a beginner, if you can inculcate this in your postures, it will help. Change the side now. Growing in yoga postures is like a tree growing in your apartment or on the floor out there in the garden. Exhale and go and hold with your right hand. If you try to force the tree to grow, it will die. If you give it too much water or too little water, it will die. Too much sunlight or too little sunlight, also it will die. It needs just the right amount of water and sunlight. In the same way, the posture needs just the right amount of stretching and rotation and movement. Rotation is a movement. So if you have the right movement and you have the right amount of ingredients in the posture, you will grow very fast. Keep working on the opposite leg. Do not let the knee of the right leg bend. Inhale and come up. Now take your hands and with a deep inhalation, lift them up. All the way up. Yeah. Now you can flex better with your feet. Now, palms facing forward, exhale and go forward. And place them wherever you can. Okay? Do not push yourself. The best yoga pose is the one that grows like a tree, remember? So, don't force yourself because you will hurt yourself. But if you just stay there and watch your breath, you yourself will not realize when your head has reached the floor. And that is the way it should be. I always ask my students, what is the most important requirement to be a 50-year-old yoga teacher? And very few people give me the answer. They say flexibility, they say strength, they say practice. The most important requirement to be a yoga teacher, a 50-year-old yoga teacher, is that you must be 50 years old. So understand that things take time and postures need to grow with you, not in spite of you being who you are. And now inhale and come up. Join your feet together, straight. This is called Dandasana, yes. Join your feet together. Now what I want you to do is, you will do Dandasana facing on this side. Yes. So take the bolster out and sit on the mat, completely facing on that side, on the mat. Take your feet under, so that after the posture you'll be able to fall back in Savasana. I always recommend highly, you might need to go a little more further, I'll always recommend highly that people do Paschimottanasana before doing Savasana. So take your hands up, exhale and go down. Focus on allowing the torso to descend. Trying to touch your toes as fast as possible is an intellectual move. Just surrendering yourself to the posture and allowing the body to descend of its own accord is the right move. Understand that. There is no competition in yoga. If you are competing with somebody else in the class, you have lost the basic meaning of yoga. Always compare with what you were doing in the previous class or the previous practice and allow the body to get better. And now slowly inhale and come up. And now fall on your back very gently without disturbing the spine, fall on your back. Push the bolster even further and just let go. Gently bring the chin down closer to the chest. Smile, relax the facial cheek muscles, drop the jaw, rest your tongue on that lowered jaw. Going back to the other end, allow the toes to fall outward and sideward. No, you're okay. No. Just that pose, yes. Just allow it to fall sidewards. It is perfectly okay to make mistakes or to misunderstand. We are not here for perfection. We are not saints. But we are willing to grow along spiritual lines. We have a set of guidelines in yoga. We use those guidelines to grow in spirituality. Just allow the whole body to descend. Yogena chittasya padena vacham malam sharirasya cha vaidyakena yopakaruttam pravaram muninam patanjalim pranjaliranatosmi avahu purusakaram sankachakra siddharinam sahasram shirasam shvetam pranamami patanjalim yastyaktva rupamadyam prabhavati jagato negadanugraya Rakshina Klesha Rashi, Vishama Vishadaro Nekavaktra Subogi, Sarvagyana Prasutir Bujaga Prityaya Yastya Nityam, Devo Isa, Vovyot Sita Vimalatanu Yogadu Yoga Yuktaha, Hari Om. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Very gently, very slowly, dragging your right leg at the heel, bring it to a bending position and place your foot on the floor. Drag the left heel and dragging it, bring it and place it by the side of the right. Bend your right arm at the elbow, the right arm, and place your head on your bent right arm as you turn to the right. Turn completely to the right, And with your left arm, pull your knees closer to you. Stay there for a while. Observe the tilted body feeling. And then slowly inhale and come and sit up, sit on the bolster. Thank you for sharing life with me today. Namaste.
So how we